Hello children, today in this video I will discuss chapter number 9 pronouns from your language textbook. Now what is a pronoun? A pronoun is a word used in place of a noun. So the word which we use in place of a noun is called a pronoun. Examples: I ordered a pizza, it was delicious. We will reach the stadium in an hour. Rustam is going on a holiday with his friends. They will reach Manali on 4th June. It is very cold today. Here in these sentences, I, it, we, they are called pronouns because they are used in place of nouns. Kinds of pronouns. Some commonly used types of pronouns are personal, demonstrative, interrogative, reflexive, emphatic, and possessive pronouns. Now in this video, I will discuss about these pronouns in details. First, we will learn about personal pronouns. First, we will see the examples. My parents have a house in Nainital. We stay there in summer. You have to work harder to pass the test. The dog is feeling hot. It is panting. The pronouns we, you and it are used in place of the names of people and animals. And these are called personal pronouns because pronouns that we use in place of names of peoples or things are called personal pronouns. If we see the last example, that is, the dog is feeling hot, it is panting. Here it is personal pronoun because it is used in place of noun dog. And what is the definition of personal pronoun? Pronouns that are used instead of names of people or things are called personal pronouns. So the pronouns which we use in place of names of peoples and things are called personal pronouns. Personal pronouns are used in the first, second and third persons. Personal pronouns of the first person refer to the speaker. They are I, we, me and us. So what are called first person personal pronouns? First person personal pronouns refer to the speaker and I, we, me and us are first person personal pronouns. The personal pronouns of the second person, you, refers to the person spoken to. So the person spoken to is called the second person personal pronoun and you is the second person personal pronoun. Personal pronouns of the third person refer to the person spoken about. So, in a sentence, third person personal pronoun refer to the person spoken about. They are he, she, it, they, them, him and her. Personal pronouns have both singular and plural forms. The table lists the various forms of personal pronouns. First person singular are I, me. Plural are we and us. We stand for we is the plural of I and us is the plural of me. Second person singular is you. Plural is also you. So you is used as singular pronoun as well as plural pronoun. Third person singular are he, him, she, her, it and plurals are they and them. The pronouns I, we, you, he, she, it and they are used as subjects of sentences. So we use I, we, you, he, she, it and they as the subjects of sentences. Now see the watch out box. Be careful about the use of I and me. Ratan and I play football together. This is a correct sentence. But if I say that Ratan and me play football together, this is an incorrect sentence. Give the book to me. This is correct. But if I say give the book to I, this is incorrect. So we have to use the pronoun I and me carefully. Next, demonstrative pronouns. What are called demonstrative pronouns? Pronouns that are used to point out specific persons or things are called demonstrative pronouns. They are this, that, these and those. So, the pronouns which we use to point out specific persons or things are called demonstrative pronouns. And this, that, these and those are called demonstrative pronouns. Examples: this is a cat. That is my book. Those are ducks. These are crows. Here, these, that, those and these are demonstrative pronouns. Because here these point out the noun cat, that point out the noun book, those point out the dog, noun ducks, and these refer to the noun crows. So they are demonstrative pronouns. These and that are used for singular nouns. These and those are used for plural nouns. So always remember, children, that we use this and that, these demonstrative pronouns, for singular nouns, and we use these and those for plural nouns. These and these point out objects that are close to the speaker. So we use this and these to point out the objects which are close to us. And we use that and those point out objects which are far away from the speaker. And we use the pronouns that and those to point out objects which are far away from us. Demonstrative pronouns and demonstrative adjectives. Now we will see the difference between demonstrative pronouns and demonstrative adjectives. Children, you have already learned about demonstrative adjectives. Demonstrative adjectives and demonstrative pronouns have the same form but perform different functions. So we know that these, that, those and these are used as demonstrative adjectives also. And here we have learned that this, that, those and these are used as demonstrative pronouns also. Now we will see the examples. Then you can understand the difference. This is my neighbor's cat. This cat belongs to my neighbor. These are scented candles. These candles are scented. In the first sentence, in each pair means this is my neighbor's cat and these are scented candles. Here, these and these refer to the nouns cat and candles. Here, this means refer to the noun cat, and here this means the candles. They are demonstrative pronouns. But in the second sentence, in each pair, like this cat belongs to my neighbor and these candles are scented, here this and these qualify or give more information about the nouns cat and candles. Here the words this and these give us more information about the noun cat and candles. So they are demonstrative adjectives. So in the first sentence, this is used as demonstrative pronoun. Third sentence, here also this is used as demonstrative pronouns, but in the second sentence this is used as demonstrative adjective, and in the fourth sentence this is also used as demonstrative adjectives. Now what are called interrogative pronouns? Pronouns that are used to ask questions about the noun are interrogative pronouns. They are who, whose, which and what. So the pronouns which we use to ask questions about the noun are called interrogative pronouns, and who, whose, which and what are called interrogative pronouns. Examples: who is that boy? Whose is this book? Which is your seat? What is his intention? Here in these sentences, who, whose, which, what are called interrogative pronouns. Now we will see the difference between interrogative pronouns and interrogative adjectives. Interrogative pronouns and interrogative adjectives take the same form but perform different functions. We have already learnt about the interrogative adjectives, and here we are learning about interrogative pronouns. Now we will see the difference between these two, that is the difference between interrogative pronouns and interrogative adjectives. Examples: which is your umbrella? Which umbrella do you want to buy? This house is beautiful. Whose is it? Whose house is this? What is today's date? What day is it today? In the first sentence, in each pair, means which is your umbrella, this house is beautiful, whose is it, and what is today's date. Here, which, whose and what refer to the nouns umbrella, house and date. The verb is comes immediately after them. See here, is come immediately after them. Here also, and they are interrogative pronouns. So when we use these words, which, whose, what, and is comes immediately after them, they are interrogative pronouns. In the second sentence, in each pair, means which umbrella do you want to buy, whose house is this, what day is it today. Here which, whose and what give more information about the nouns umbrella, house and day. They come immediately before the nouns they describe. So here which comes before the noun umbrella, in this sentence whose comes before the noun house, and in the last sentence what comes before the noun day. So they come immediately before the nouns they describe. They are interrogative adjectives. Now students, I think all of you have understood this clearly. This is the lesson for today. I will continue this chapter in the next video. Till then, practice all the exercises which you have already done in your online classes. Bye, students.